church.
Like I tell Jesse every Sunday, it's always funny when it's somebody else's kids. All right, y'all gonna have to bear with me. I have a whole bulletin full of stuff, information, and then stuff coming in at the last minute. So if you please bear with me. Hopefully Greg's lesson's short. And then that way we'll get out at the same time. If it's not, you're here for a while. All right, prayer requests. And if you don't have a bulletin, again, like Jesse gets up here and talks about classes all the time. When I get up here, I talk about the bulletin. Because there's a lot of hard work and thought that actually goes into the bulletin that sometimes we just kind of miss because we don't pick them up. But they're everywhere. They're out here on the on the information table. They're here on the corners. They're in the back. So if you could pick you up one, it does have some great information in it about members of our church and their families. Our prayer request, Shanda Reeves did get to come home from the hospital from Murray Regional. Misty Fite's grandfather, James Graham, is still in Murray Regional, and we want to continue prayers for him. Was informed this morning that Miss Glenda Mitchell was found unresponsive this morning. They had to life flight her. And no other information we have right now. And if anybody else has got any more, hey, throw it out there. But keep her in your prayers. And for those of you who don't know Glenda, she's the sister of Lily and Frankie. Lily and Frankie, and they were both teachers here. And Glenda used to work at the hospital with my mother. Sweetest people, sweet people. Okay, I have a card of thanks, and this throws me off every time. Thank you for the cards, the texts, the phone calls, and most of all the prayers during Bull's recovery from surgery. And then it says Richard and Connie Clayton. Bull, we love you, but I don't know who Richard is. Our house churches will meet tonight, this week, for the final time until January. Thank you for all those who have hosted groups in your homes and facilitated these gatherings. Winterfest will be held in Gatlinburg, February the 17th through the 19th of 2023. This is an amazing event that will bring you closer to God. If you and your family are interested in attending, please let Greg know so that we can start making plans for the group. And I promise you, if you have never been, you need to go at least one time. Just to get the full effect of what 5,000 and some odd people singing at a venue like that. That in and of itself is amazing, along with all the different speakers that you get to hear. This afternoon, we'll be putting up the Christmas tree and other Christmas decorations. If you're available to help, be here at 4:00. And we say this every year, but it never happens, but I'm gonna say it again. Go out and buy a little ornament. It don't have to be anything elaborate. Put your and the family's names on it so we can put it on the tree. We still have some from 80s. We have ornaments from the 80s. with people's names on them, and it's kind of comical for some of us that put them up sometimes. We're like, do we need to get rid of this ornament? They've got 12 more over here. That's all right. Bring an ornament. Put it on the tree. You don't have to bring it tonight. If you want to bring it next Sunday, put it on the tree. But we want you to be represented on the Hornwall Church of Christ Christmas tree as people drive by the building. That's the one thing that they will see, because it's going to be centrally located. And speaking of Christmas, the annual Christmas parade will be this Thursday. That's hard to believe. This Thursday, December the 1st at 7 o'clock. We also, every year, take this opportunity to serve hot chocolate to the community. And that does not take place without the help of people. So if we can get volunteers to serve hot chocolate, I'll be here about 5:30. And if you can help out, see Greg. We'll also be having the Christmas dinner Sunday, December the 11th. The meat will be provided, but bring side dishes or a dessert and join us around 5 p.m. Again, that's December the 11th. Okay. If you are helping with Breakfast with Santa or would like to help, please meet immediately after services today down in the front of the auditorium. Usually that's right here. Upcoming events. We talked about the Christmas parade December the 1st. December the 3rd will be Breakfast with Santa. December the 10th, a scavenger hunt. Young Adult Christmas Scavenger Hunt will be Saturday, December the 10th from 2 o'clock until y'all find your stuff. We will meet at the Hornwall CFC lobby at 2 o'clock. Be sure to sign up by December the 4th. And then we have the Christmas dinner, December the 11th. Breakfast with Santa. Okay, if you're interested in sponsoring a child at the Trujillo Christian School, there is literature on the table in the front lobby. If you're interested in going on the work trip this coming summer, please let Greg put your name on the list. Not a firm commitment as of yet. The dates to the mission trip will be June the 25th through July the 5th of next year, 2023. All right, and then we'll end with happy birthdays. Happy birthday, Jackson Fight, November the 28th. Calix Feitinger, November the 30th. Glenda Goodman, November the 30th. Trinity and Tristan Bollock on December the 3rd. Happy birthday. Are there any other announcements? All right, if you would, please join in. Oh, wait a minute, I forgot. It's been a while since I've did this. The scripture, Psalm 34:15. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to their cry. Amen. If you would, please join in, Brother Hayden, with the singing.
If you'll stand with me, please. We'll sing three songs this morning before we have our opening prayer.
Oh, Lord, people praise you.
Bow with me, please. Father in heaven, you truly are the one, the only one, the holy one. Father, we pray that we live our lives in a way that reflects that we acknowledge your presence, your sovereignty over all the universe, and especially here in our lives, Father, that we should yield our wants and desires to be wholly dedicated to you. Father, this morning we come before you and we ask for special blessings on a number of people. We ask you especially, Father, to be with Glenda Mitchell. Be with Linda and Lily and Frankie, Father, and for their concerns. And we just pray, Father, that you be with them in this very difficult, challenging time. And we pray if it is your will that Glenda will recover. Father, these ladies are so special, not just to a few of us here, but to so many in this community. We just ask that your loving hand be upon this entire situation. Father, we ask you to bless Chanda Reeves and help her, Father, to fully recover from her illness. Ask you to be with Ron Riley as he is still recovering from his fall. Be with Jerry Mercer and as he continues to struggle with the pain in his back. Be with Chloe as she has upcoming treatments, Father. And we just pray that your loving hand will be upon all those And Father, as we are in this season of the fall and almost winter with so much flu and RSV and pneumonia raging, we just pray that you'll help us to stay as healthy as possible, to take care of ourselves and take precautions so that none of us may be affected by these illnesses. Father, we're thankful this morning that our brother Bull Clayton is able to be back with us, and it's so encouraging to see him to be able to be here and to get around. Father, we thank you for this season of Thanksgiving that we're still in, Father, and we just pray that every day is a day of Thanksgiving for us. We ask you, Father, that we pray that the effort last week with the Sack the Pulpit was an opportunity and a successful one that we might show our love to those in this community that are less fortunate than us, Father, that we can share some of the love of Jesus with them. Father, we ask you tonight, this evening, to bless the house churches that meet. We're thankful for the love and friendship and getting to know one another better on a deeper level, Father, and talking about your word in our homes as we should every day. We ask you, Father, this morning to be with Greg and the message he delivers, Father, that it may stir us to be closer to you. And Father, we pray this morning as Hayden continues to lead us in song that our words and our hearts may be lifting up beautiful aroma to you, Father, that our worship may be pleasing in your sight. And bless our time of communion, Father, this morning, that we might be drawn closer to one another and closer to our brothers and sisters in Christ and to you. We ask all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus, and amen.
After this song, we will partake in the Lord's Supper.
Reading God of your proclaim. Said unto them, this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many. Verily I say unto you, I will drink no more of the fruit of the vine until that day that I drink of it, and then drink it new in the kingdom of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I want to thank thee for the bread, which is us as Christians, represents the body of Christ on that cruel cross of Calvary that he gave for us. May those who partake of it do so in a well-pleasing manner unto thee. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Shed on that cruel cross of Calvary for all of us and our sins. May those who partake of this now also do so in a well-pleasing manner unto thee. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Heavenly Father, I want to thank thee for this day that you've given us, that you allow us to be able to get up and healthily and go do our jobs every day, that we can supply money for our families, that we can all live on. Now we come to this time of the week which we can give to thee a portion we wish we have been blessed with in this prior week, so that the work of the church can continue. We ask thee now to go with us through the rest of this week. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
You'll stand with me, please.
We'll sing two songs and then Greg will deliver his message.
How do you explain?